Evgeni Plushenko's emotional speech showed that the entire school of Plushenko's angels agreed with this statement. Plushenko's statement was as follows. I have this statement. My athletes, who do Ultra C, for some reason are given much lower scores. But the jumps are great, the jumps are super. If someone else did those jumps, they would give completely different scores. I looked at the printouts, an order of magnitude higher for others. Mine, if there are any ribs, they can see it right away. The other athletes didn't. I think, what's wrong? And this has been going on for several years. I talked to the judges, to the federation. I said, look, you judge me severely. Why? You judge everyone equally. We're for justice, aren't we? For justice. And I've been saying that for the second year. I tell them, I warn them, I remind them before the competitions. The federation says, everything will be all right. And again no, and again, and again, and again. I was patient. Today we talked to the athletes and the parents. Most probably there will be a transfer to other countries. Many athletes. The ones who are being judged unfairly. Because the guys and I have to fight for justice. I'm already tired. If the federation does not need us, our figure skating, then we will go where we are needed. But the federation says to me, so go away, it's okay. Phew. That's great. That's great. I will talk to the Ministry of Sports, to the ROC. I have no conflicts, but when they make me leave. I am a kind, decent man, I do for the country, I make schools, I build schools, we do together with Yana. Now we are opening a school. What is it for? So that my school will know, ah, this is Plushenko's angels, we're drowning. Tired, bored. Here is such an official statement. Then Evgeni explained that he had already had offers from other countries, but he had previously restrained the impulses of his athletes. But they are not in slavery, and the parents, allegedly observing all this judicial bacchanalia, offered themselves. And he, the coach, has to support them. I have to fight, because if I took this path of a coach, a manager, I finance them, I help them, I coach them every day from morning till night. I also have to advocate for my athletes. I mean, they're just jerks, but they're top athletes. Of course, he was immediately labeled a traitor, and, of course, the first voices came from Ateri Tutberidze's group. You know, to put it mildly, given today's political situation and the way we are loved, in quotes, it is too ugly, too much for a person of that rank to say such things. Just because it seemed to Evgeny Viktorovich that his athletes are being sued, they have to change their sports citizenship? In general, it sounds like a betrayal. It's not even nice to talk about such things, let alone think about it. Alexei Zeleznyakov, a choreographer from the Tutberidze team, and Plushenko's longtime opponent in absentee arguments, told RIA Novosti. However, Plushenko calls such accusations ridiculous. When people say that the performance of athletes under a neutral flag is treason, it's ridiculous to me. The sport's age is very short. If you have an opportunity to compete, you need to take it. Everyone will know what country the Russian athletes represent, Plushenko told the same source. In the figure skating world, Plushenko is probably understood. But as Tatiana Tarasova advised, no one needs to know and no one needs to say it. But the most frightening thing is that everyone, including Zeleznyakov, confirmed that the judging is bad. It happens that the referees underattended or turned a blind eye to something. But Evgeny Viktorovich thinks that only his athletes are humiliated and sued, Zeleznyakov said indignantly. It turns out that everyone is humiliated? Will they listen to what Plushenko says? No one here listens to anyone. Judges don't give a damn about anyone, Tatiana Anatolievna said in a commentary for Sport 24. And what's next? RIA Novosti reported, citing an unnamed source, that the federations of major European countries are interested in the possible transition of Russian skaters Veronika Zhilina and Sofia Titova. But so far, These are only rumors and innuendo from Plushenko himself. But so far he is not in danger. According to Match TV, the Figure Skating Federation won't consider Yevgeny Plushenko's statements for their compliance with the organization's code of ethics, even though the new code requires coaches to avoid publicly condemning in an incorrect and rude manner the results of competitions and decisions of the judging panel. Coach Sofia Fedchenko commented on the judging at the Russian Junior Figure Skating Championship. Fedchenko's pupil Alina Gorbacheva took first place, and Plushenko's skaters Veronika, Zhilina and Sofia Titova took second and fourth place respectively. As a professional, have you noticed the bias against Evgeny Plushenko's pupils? Titova would have gotten more for the free skating, if she hadn't been 16th after the short one. My athletes, including Alina, were in such situations more than once. If you do the free skating in the first warm-up, your go-in components will be lower than if you're in the leader's warm-up. It doesn't matter at all if you're Titova, Gorbacheva or someone else. There's a good expression, you can't win a tournament with a short program, but you can lose. So, Yevgeny Viktorovich's athletes lost their places precisely because of the short program. Going back to Titova. Well, okay, she would have got more, by how much? A rib on the Lutz cost her 2,44 points, 7,16 for Gordieva, versus 4,72 for Titova. What else didn't satisfy Yevgeny Viktorovich? A tick on the somersault? Okay, without a tick, Salcho with a fall is 4.85, Titova's is 3.88, the difference is slightly less than a point. We end up with a 3.41 conditional bias against Titova. The difference with Gordieva, they have 14 points. Is it worth saying anything else? Why then, in your opinion, did the Olympic champion get carried away? I think he was too confident of his victory in the absence of the main favorite of the tournament, Elisa Diva-Glazova. Well, you'll have to get used to reckoning with different coaching staffs. We have youngsters growing up. Sofia, in your coaching career, have you ever faced a biased refereeing? I never discuss the work of the officiating staff, it's beyond my competence. I have another task, to teach my athletes to skate without errors. I always tell my children, skate in such a way that there is nothing to pick on, even if someone really wants to. Was it offensive for you, as the coach of the winner of the tournament, to hear such an emotional speech from Yevgeny Viktorovich? It turns out that he kind of hinted that Alina is not very worthy of her place. This is not the person whose opinion matters to me, said Fedchenko.